Hey, what's up guys? This is your friend Manak from Civil Center and I welcome all of you back to our channel. So friends, in this video, we'll show you how to perform interactive design in TSD or Tekla Structural Designer. So let us get started. So first of all, we'll select any of our member. Suppose this column we'll select. And then we'll simply right click on it and then we'll go to our design member static. So you can see that we have designed this member and the sections of this member are 250 into 300 and the longitudinal bars are 4 numbers of bars of 16 mm for 4 and also we have 416 and 2 numbers of 12 mm bars. As you can see, this is a G+2 building, so it is showing all these layers. So this column is safe for 4 numbers of 16 mm and 2 numbers of 12 mm and the size of the section of the column is 250 into 300. So let us see if we can change that. So for that, we'll just close this and then right click on it again and go to interactive design static. So now as you can see that we have C1, C2, C3 and C14. So C11 is our from foundation to plinth level. C12 is our plinth level to ground floor and C13 is our ground floor slab to our first floor slab. Similarly, C14 is first floor slab to second floor slab. So we'll go to this C12, that is from our foundation, that is from our plinth level to our ground floor slab. So we have the size here, which is 250 into 300. And as you can see, these ratios, these are all pass. So what if we change this size? Say we'll change this size to 250 into 250. Let us find out if the section is passed or failed. So the section fails here, as you can see this ratio. Here also you can see. So for 250 into 250, the design will not get passed. So we'll simply change it to 250 into 300. Also we can check and change the orientation and look at the difference. As you can see, this ratio is 0.801 and 0.322. What if we change this to 300 into 250? You can see these ratios have increased. So this orientation of 250 into 300 is the better one. Now, as you can see that we have some markings here. That is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now the principal bar size is 16 mm. So we have 4 numbers of 16 mm at the 4 corners. Now in between we have intermediate bar size of 12 mm. Between 1 to 2 we have not provided any number of 12 mm bars. As you can see, between 1 to 2 and between 3 to 4 we don't have any bars. So this count of 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 is 0. Now between 2 to 3 and 4 to 1, that is 2 to 3 this one and 4 to 1 this one, we have provided bars of 12 mm. So what if we remove this? Suppose we want to just simply remove this and make it 0. So we have made both these 0. Now let us check if the section is passed or section fails. So as you can see that the section is okay, but the ratio increases. So we can also do this design using 4 numbers of 16 mm bars and of the size 250 into 300. So in this way we can do the interactive design. So what if we change the principal bar size from 16 mm to 12 mm? Let us check if the section will be passed or not. So as you can see, the section has failed again. So we need minimum 16 mm bars of 4 numbers. Now let us go and check our ties in columns, which is called links here. So as you can see, the ties have been provided at a spacing of 150 mm and the diameter of the tie bars is 8 mm. So we'll simply change this to 175 and let us check if it limit checks passed or failed. So as you can see, the limit checks have failed. So let us again increase this tie diameter to 10 mm. Then also it fails. So we'll just change it to 8 mm and change this to back to 150. So we have 8mm tie bars at a spacing of 150mm. So by using this interactive design, we can also check the design of our ties as well as our main reinforcement. So that's all for today. In this video, we have learned how to use the interactive design in Tekla Structural Designer. So see you in the next video. Bye for now.